All right, guys, we're here at the Visa Center. We got the first appointment of the morning. It's 7 something in the morning, and we want to be able to get in here, meet our appointment. All right, guys, not good. It looks like they can't print out visas here. Just want to let you know that many of you don't understand how hard it is for us to be able to do this every year. All right, so everyone knew last year if Hadi Choopan was here a little bit earlier, there could have been a big difference with his outcome. Finally he's here, thank God. Thank God, guys. We finally got him here. Hadi Choopan is here in America.
Times when you're aspiring to achieve great things, you're gonna have the naysayers come out, you know. And some are like family or friends that are.
I call it white noise. There's always gonna be negative people out there.
Yeah,
they're gonna talk crap
noise.
Yeah, and if you just set your mind to do something, you know, you just have to be persistent, work hard. You know, like my dad, you know, set that in my head. It's like work hard, and you will reap the rewards. If you just sit back and think it's going to be handed in your lap, you're not going to get this.
It's not going to happen, though.
You know, I really believe in positive affirmation. You hear a lot about now positive affirmation. You put in your head over and over that you're going to be able to accomplish something, that it will happen. And I was so positively that I was gonna be Mr. America and Mr. Universe that year. And I knew that if I was gonna move to California, that I was gonna take California by storm. My mindset, I was so focused and driven to be this great bodybuilder. I felt it was destined that I was gonna become a great bodybuilder. Even though I was told I didn't have the genetics, I didn't have the knowledge, there was no way that I was going to be this great bodybuilder. And I just said, I'm going to do it.
Life is a battleground, and every one of us has our battles to fight. Some of us step into the ring as underdogs, doubted by others, and sometimes even by ourselves. But it's not where you start that defines you, it's where you finish. I've been a fighter all my life, and as a bodybuilder, I was always the underdog. But let me tell you something, being the underdog is a blessing in disguise. When you're an underdog, the world doesn't expect you to win. People doubt you, they tell you that you're not good enough, that you don't have what it takes. But it's in those moments, when the world is against you, that you have the chance to dig deep and find out who you really are. Your legacy isn't built in a day, it's built day by day. Every time you choose discipline over laziness, every time you choose to push harder instead of giving up, you're writing your legacy. You're showing the world, and more importantly yourself, that you are someone who never gives up, who fights for every inch, who will not be defeated by life's challenges. Success isn't about avoiding risk or waiting for the perfect moment. It's about having the courage to take that leap of faith, even when you're unsure of the outcome. It's about waking up every day, making your bed, and starting your day with small wins that build the foundation for bigger victories. Remember, it's not about where you start, it's about how you finish. The future is not some distant point in time, it's created by the decisions you make today. Make decisions that your future self will thank you for. Decide to be strong. Decide to be relentless. Decide to be the best version of yourself. And when you do, you'll not only transform your own life, but you'll inspire everyone around you to do the same. I was told there was no way I would become a great bodybuilder. They said I didn't have the genetics, the background, or the resources. But guess what? I didn't listen. I used every doubt, every criticism as motivation to push harder, to train longer, to become not just a bodybuilder, but one of the best. Being the underdog taught me the value of hard work, of resilience, of never giving up, no matter what. It taught me to focus on what I could control, my effort, my attitude, my commitment. And with that mindset, I was able to climb to the top, to become a bodybuilding champion, and eventually a successful entrepreneur. But here's the thing, it wasn't just about winning trophies or titles. It was about proving to myself that I could achieve anything I set my mind to. It was about cultivating a champion's mentality, a mentality that says, no matter what comes my way, I will find a way to overcome it. I will find a way to win. From the moment I stepped into the gym as a skinny kid with big dreams, I knew I was going to have to work harder, push further, and believe deeper than anyone else around me. The world told me I couldn't, that I didn't have the genetics, the strength, the potential to become great, but I didn't listen, because deep inside, I knew I was destined for something greater. Every weight I lifted, every set I pushed through, every drop of sweat that fell, each one was a step closer to my goal. I knew that the pain, the sacrifice, and the struggle were all necessary. They were shaping me, building me not just as a bodybuilder, but as a warrior in life. To those of you facing your own battles, I say this: embrace the struggle. Lean into the discomfort. Let the doubt from others be the fire that drives you forward. There will be days when it feels like the world is against you, but those are the days when champions are made. Those are the days when you dig deep, find your strength, and keep moving forward. No matter how strong the storm, stand tall, fight hard, and never stop believing in yourself. I stood on the stage with giants, men who were stronger, bigger, and more experienced than me, but I didn't see them as unbeatable. I saw them as challenges, as motivation. Every time I was told I couldn't, it fueled my determination. I used that doubt, that skepticism, as the very reason to push harder. Remember, it's not about being the biggest or the strongest. It's about being the one who refuses to give up, the one who gets up every time they're knocked down, the one who believes in their own greatness even when no one else does.
I think that you'll agree that motivation is one thing, discipline is another. Discipline is I think, the mindset that makes champions, and it's the ability, discipline is the ability to do the hard things over and over and over again, even when you don't want to do.
Life isn't a sprint, it's a marathon. And like any race, it's not just about speed, but about endurance, tenacity, and the will to keep pushing forward. Even when the road gets tough, we all face challenges, whether it's health, aging, or the daily grind. But it's how we respond to those challenges that defines us. Take a lesson from the champions of yesterday and today. Those who have reached the pinnacle of success didn't do so because they avoided failure. No, they succeeded because they embraced it. They understood that each setback was a stepping stone, a lesson, a chance to pivot and grow. They learned to fail forward. It's easy to be complacent, to tell yourself that you're doing just fine. But deep down, you know that fine isn't good enough. Fine isn't what makes legends. Fine won't give you the life you dream of. It's not about being perfect. It's about striving for greatness every single day. It's about setting your standards high and not settling for anything less than what you're truly capable of. There will be moments when it feels like too much, when you're tired, when the results aren't coming as fast as you want. But remember, the greatest achievements come when you push past the pain, past the doubt, past the point where most people quit. That's where the magic happens. That's where you find out who you really are.
Afraid of what others are going to think. They feel you can't care about what others think. You just have to do what you need to do to get to your goal.